I do a lot of, obviously, core work, and I don't do crunches for the most part because you don't need to, and they kill your neck and your back. No reason to. But you've got to get the lower, deep, transverse abdominal muscles. You've got to get the obliques properly. You've got to have low body fat
in the kitchen for the most part.
Depends on the way your stomach muscles are made. Some of us have better stomach muscles. They look better as we get leaner. I carry my fat in my hips, the junk in the trunk, in this magazine that are very different because they look kind of, I don't know, interesting. So let's check them out. So this is kind of what it looks like here. And the first one is a plank. We all know about planks. So I'm not going to spend time on a plank because you should know that a side plank is critical. And you know, when you line up your elbow and your shoulder, right? You stack your hands. I have a mirror. I'm hoping I'm stacked up. A lot of variations. You can stick a towel between your knees. You can do all kinds of stuff on a side plank. You should be doing
side planks.
Let's see here. Okay, round back targets rectus and transversus abdominis.
This one right here. So
can you see it? Can you see it? Yeah, it's that one right there. Okay, we're gonna try that. Although she has better legs than me and she's taller. That's why she has better legs, because she's taller, of course. No, that's not true. I like to think that.
The deep pelvic floor muscles that wrap 360 degrees and make your stomach strong and hold it in. These are not the sexy crunches. This isn't the sexy six pack, but you gotta have this stuff. Hello, people. Wake up.
Okay, so lift feet off floor. Okay, squeeze abs. Okay,
feel
abs, your quadriceps, right? Because you're lifting with your quad.
I could go like
this. Press into the ground. Back is rounded, it says. Back is rounded. And this is from fitnessmagazine.com, April 2011, by the way. So you can look it up. Okay, or you can go like this. But you got to pull your tummy in when you do it. Because I'm noticing that if I stick my stomach out, it doesn't work. So I got to pull it in, belly button to spine, and then lift toes up. Press my fingers into the ground.
Press your fingers.
Try both. Press. Okay, you know what? I feel it in the lower region of the stomach.
What they call flat
back, which is targeting rectus and transverse again. And again, very different move. Let me show you a picture of it because I got to make sure that I don't look too goofy doing this.
It's a lovely move if you're in a co-ed gym.
Probably want to do this one at home, ladies, because it's, you know, it's just going to invite weird looks and thoughts and, you know, being uncomfortable and self-conscious.
Okay, so I'm going to separate here,
and my fingers go in between. Wow. Okay. And then I'm going to push against the wall, low back flat, and lift. Oh, geez. Wow, you can feel it. Wowzer. Pull my tummy in tight, stomach tight. Make sure I exhale during the exertion. One at a time. Can you see what I'm doing? I'm lifting up. Oh my gosh.
So I'm happy to add just a couple new exercises if they really do work. And boy, did I feel this in the lower region of my stomach.
And if you have a piece of equipment I'm going to show you now in the gym where you work, then you definitely want to use this. It's a Tower Power. You do pull-ups on it, but it's awesome for knee ups where the few times I really get sore in my stomach work, doing something new, of course, and more reps or using weight with crunches or whatever, rope crunches, not regular crunches, and then the Tower Power usually does it. So I'll show you what this is.
See, that's where we can do our pull-ups, and then this can come up here.
So if you have one of these machines in your gym, then you need to be working this. Make sure that it doesn't hurt your low back, so you're not leaning into it. Wherever it fits, mine kind of is in the low back area. I'm just going to hold myself, make sure you're not losing your neck up. Knees can come in. It can come to the side. You can hold straight legs. Turn to the side.
If you have
a lot of hanging like this and you want to make it even harder, you can go with an under grip or you can go with an over grip. And you can do them this way. Or you can hold this way. But make sure you're not like this. See the difference? Up, retract the shoulders back before you start, and up. Exhale. Pull from the lower region of your stomach.
Use it if you start swinging a lot. You just don't have probably the strength maybe yet. Your hands might get tired. Shake it out. Take a break and keep doing it. But good
this
stuff.
This trusty tool here,
right? You grab a hold of it. You do crunches. You know, you do crunches from the side. Call them wood choppers. This right here, love these. You can be doing side to side with the knees up. You can even toss it in the air and catch it. You can bounce it side to side on a bench. It's definitely going to work you. What else? Oh, where is
my
one of these big giant half moon, half dome things? You sit on this. I like to lift it even overhead. Take it into a modified burpee.
Before I sign out, I decided I haven't done my workout yet.
Not with me.
I wonder if I can blast up.
Keeping good form. No camels, number 5. No seals, number 6. Shh. Shh. Stomach tight.
What are you doing today? Have you done your workout yet? Have you done your workout at all? Do you work out at all? Do you move? Do you eat well? What do you do? Just your tip here to say to you, come on, people. Life is too short. All right? Get going. Come on. Let's get going. Don't make me come find you. Don't make me come find you. It won't be pretty. That's what I'd say.